And welcome back to another video from my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. And in today's video we are going to talk about the pest resistant plants. So it requires a particular mechanism to make a plant resistant from pest, which is quite important topic from examination point of view. इसीलिए आपसे interaction करना काफी जरूरी था. So I thought कि ये video में bold पे बनाऊं. So let's talk about some general things. We know very well about pest and we know very well about parasites. Parasites are some organism which live on some other organism and derive nutrition from it. That's why they are quite harmful for a particular organism, because they are deriving nutrition and they are interfering with different kind of metabolic activities of a particular organism. तो कोई भी parasitic organism जब हमारी body में enter करता है तो वो हमारी metabolism के साथ छेड़छाड़ शुरू कर देता है, as well as वो हमारी body से nutrition derive करने लग जाता है. वो blood flow के through कहीं भी जा सकता है body में. So it is quite harmful for us, and the same thing is with pest. Pest also derive nutrients as well as they send some gene into the plants which are quite harmful for them. Okay, so they cause different kind of diseases in plants. So it is very important to remove pest as well as to remove the effect of parasites in case of plants to make them healthy. Unko acche se healthy rakhne ke liye bahut zyada zaruri hai to remove the pest as well as to remove the parasites. In last lecture हमने बात की थी pest के बारे में, about the pest control. We have talked about the BT cotton, okay, and the mechanism to kill that particular insect. लेकिन इस particular lecture में हम बात करेंगे about the parasite. So there are a lot of organisms which are parasitic in nature, but जो सबसे ज़्यादा effect करते हैं एक particular plant को, these are parasitic nematodes. What are nematodes? Let's talk about it. आप सबने एनिमल किंगडम में क्लासिफिकेशन पढ़ी होगी, ओके? तो क्लासिफिकेशन में यू हैव श्योरली हर्ड अबाउट प्लैटीहेल्मिंथस एंड एस्केल्मिंथस, राइट? फ्लैट वॉर्म्स एंड राउंड वॉर्म्स. सो दीज आर द राउंड वॉर्म्स. जो राउंड वॉर्म्स हमने पढ़े थे, एस्केरियसिस एंड डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ हुक वॉर्म, दीज ऑल आर राउंड वॉर्म्स. सो वो जो राउंड वॉर्म है, समटाइम्स दे आर पैरासिटिक, ओके? दे मे बी एंडोपैरासाइट और दे मे बी एक्टोपैरासाइट, दैट इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन whether they live inside the body of a particular organism or outside. So the nematodes affect a lot of organisms. काफी सारे organisms को ये kill कर सकता है. They may be plant. It means that the nematodes may affect plant, or they may affect animals also, including human beings. Human beings में भी काफी सारी ऐसे disease है जो कि nematodes से होती है. So these are parasitic nematodes and they may affect plant as well as animals, including human beings. So a particular specific nematode that we are going to talk about in this lecture is Melodigini incarnisia. Okay, Melodigini incarnisia. This is a kind of parasitic nematode. Okay, this is the name is quite important. ये कहाँ act करता है, किस plant पे act करता है, ये सारी चीजें बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी हैं. Okay, so you must remember the name of this nematode. Firstly, you have to remember one thing, that this is nematode. This is not protozoan. This is not bacteria. This is nematode. Okay. So this is a kind of nematode named Melodigini incarnisia, and it affects the root of tobacco plant. Okay, for example, this is the root of tobacco plant. This is the root. Let's talk about root. This is the root. Then it affects the root of tobacco plant. That's why it decreases the yield of tobacco plant. This is the incarnisia, okay? This is the parasitic nematode. That's why it kills the root, okay? And when it kills the root, there are a lot of problems in absorbing water, in absorbing minerals. That's why the tobacco's yield, the tobacco's production will decrease. This is quite important. So Melodigini incarnisia, it will bind the root of tobacco plant. That's why it will affect the roots. It will kill the roots. And क्या होगा उसकी वजह से? Tobacco की yield जो है कम हो जाएगी. This is its effect. But nowadays we have adopted some kind of technologies, okay? Some kind of things, some kind of mechanisms which may prevent this particular root from this infection. काफी सारे infective agents से बचाने के लिए हमारे पास आजकल काफी सारे mechanisms आ चुके हैं, which are biological in nature. These are related to technology as well as biology. So these are biotechnological applications जो कि हम use कर सकते हैं to prevent a particular plant. How? There is a mechanism of cellular defense. Cellular means it is present in cells and it is providing us the defense against a particular parasite, against a particular pathogen. Okay, तो कुछ particular चीज है जो कि defense provide करती है. And this particular mechanism about which we are talking in this lecture, that is RNA interference, is present in all eukaryotic cells. कोई भी eukaryotic cells हो सकते हैं वो किसी particular animal के किसी particular जो complex animal है उसका cell हो सकता है, वो human being का cell हो सकता है, it can be the cell of plant, it can be any eukaryotic cell. So in any eukaryotic cell there is a common mechanism of cellular defense that is known as RNAi, which is known as RNA interference. Okay? अब हम लोग एक कहानी पढ़ेंगे बिल्कुल छोटी सी, बिल्कुल सिंपल, जो हम काफी बार पढ़ चुके हैं. A very simple story. We know very well about DNA replication. DNA makes DNA with a process called replication. DNA then makes mRNA with a process called transcription. And the mRNA will then synthesize proteins, will then form products, will then form enzymes with the help of a process that is known as translation, because it will form protein and protein is a form of expression. Okay, or we can say that it forms enzymes. So hame kya karna hai? As the name of this particular technique indicates, RNA interference, we have to interfere this particular mechanism in the stage of mRNA. Okay, let's take an overview. This is DNA. Okay, this is double-stranded DNA. It will form then mRNA and it will then form proteins, which will then form products. Okay, if we will stop this particular mechanism of central dogma in this mRNA stage pe hi rok diya is process ko, so there will be no translation. Obviously, if we will stop this particular mechanism on stage of mRNA, then there will be no translation. If there is no translation, there is no protein formation, there is no expression, there is no enzyme formation, and the expression in case of parasitic animals or in case of pathogen is the disease causing thing, the disease causing chemical. Okay, har cheez protein based hai. All the things are dependent on expression and all the expressions are dependent on translation. In this particular case, we are stopping translation, we are not letting translation to occur. It simply means that we are stopping the synthesis of protein, we are stopping the synthesis of expression. Jab expression hi nahi hoga, jab protein ya enzyme hi nahi banega, to bimari kahan se hogi? I hope you got it. So hum kya karenge? This is the mRNA and we will stop this process because the parasitic nematodes or all the pathogens have some kind of genes. Wo genes hamari body mein aakar translate karte hain to make some proteins. Okay, the genes of parasites or pathogens translate in our body to make some toxic proteins or toxic enzymes which are harmful for us. So if we will stop the translation of pathogenic gene, then we can easily get prevented from disease. That's quite simple. So mRNA hai, isko stop kaise karenge? There are some complementary RNA. Okay, you know very well about complementarity, hum molecular basis of inheritance padh chuke hain. So the complementary RNA is having the same sequence as the mRNA. It will then bind to the mRNA and will stop its synthesis into proteins. Kyunki zahir si baat hai, this work in an efficient manner when it is single stranded. But when the double stranded complementary DNA will bind to it, it will degrade the mRNA. So it will now cannot translate to form some kind of proteins. It means that we have silenced that RNA. This is also known as RNA silencing. Okay, you don't need to know very much about the RNA interference, but I will, you know, tell you some points about it. This is double stranded complementary RNA. Kahan se aata hai double stranded RNA? Because double stranded RNA is not usually present in our body. Hamari body mein single stranded RNA hai. It will come from different kind of pathogens. When some virus attack our body in which RNA is the genetic material, to wahan se RNA aa sakta hai. In some cases there are some genetic elements, mobile genetic elements, which are, you know, can travel from one place to other. These are known as transposons. Okay, those transposons or those viral DNA can get into our body and it can make double stranded RNA structure, and this double stranded RNA structure can form different kind of RNAs. It can form miRNA, it can form siRNA, it can form shRNA. All these RNA will then react on this particular mRNA template and will stop it to translate. It will not let this particular mRNA to translate to make proteins. जाहिर सी बात है, जो complementary RNA है जो हमारी body में आया है from virus, virus आया है तो अपना genome भी लेकर आएगा, उसका genome हमारी body में present होगा as RNA. या फिर there are some mobile genetic elements, transposons जो कि हमारी body में enter कर जाते हैं, उनकी वजह से हमारी body में आ जाएगा एक complementary RNA which can get transformed into siRNA, shRNA या फिर miRNA and all these RNAs will then act on this single-stranded mRNA template to either degrade it or either silence it. जिसके बाद it will not let the translation to occur. There will be no protein synthesis, there will be no expression, there will be no enzyme formation, there will be no toxic substance generation. It means that we have silenced the pathogen. हमने pathogen को भी silence कर दिया है क्योंकि हमने protein synthesis को रोक दिया. That's quite simple. Okay? So this is the mechanism of RNAi, that is RNA interference or RNA silencing. Okay, these siRNA, shRNA, miRNA will form some complexes with some kind of proteins. Okay, or wo pura complex aake ispe attack kar deta hai, it will degrade it or either silence it. This is the mechanism. Okay, so let's revise it once again. There are some sort of pathogens, there are some parasites which are nematodic in nature. It means that they are belonging to roundworms family and most common among them is Melodigini incognita, which affect the roots of tobacco. This is quite important. It will affect the roots, point one. It will affect the tobacco plant, point two. And it is a nematode, point three. These are quite important to understand. Now, we are having a mechanism of cellular defense. All eukaryotic cells are having some mechanism of cellular defense that is known as RNAi technology. And in that particular technology, the mRNA is silenced or mRNA is inactivated with the help of double-stranded complementary RNA. This is double-stranded in nature. You must note that. Okay? The mRNA template is obviously single-stranded. We have already talked about the replication, transcription, translation in previous lectures. So you know about this very well. But the complementary RNA is double-stranded in nature. You have to note it down. Okay? It will silence the mRNA. Therefore, there will be no synthesis of protein. There will be no action of pathogen further. That's why we have silenced a particular pathogen. This is how we have inhibited the synthesis of proteins. Okay, this is the mechanism. Now we have talked about the Agarobacterium tumefaciens as well as retroviruses in previous chapter. हमने बात की थी वहाँ पे that there are some specific vectors to carry the gene of interest into host organisms. If we want to carry the gene of interest into plants, then we will choose Agarobacterium tumefaciens. And if we want to send that particular gene of interest into animals, then we will choose retrovirus. Pura lecture humne ispe padha hai. Let's take an overview because this is also given in this chapter. So Agarobacterium is quite important because it has some genes that are tumor inducing and retrovirus have also some genes which are cancer causing. तो ये जो ट्यूमर इंड्यूसिंग जीन्स है, we have to replace those tumor cells, tumor genes from these vectors and we have to insert the gene of interest in that place so that वो कॉज करेंगे जाके डिजीज, तो वो क्या करेंगे, ट्यूमर जीन की जगह हमारा जीन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट दे देंगे इनटू द होस्ट सेल. दैट्स व्हाई दीस आर आल्सो यूज्ड एज वेक्टर्स. दे विल सेंड आवर जीन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट व्हिच इज रिप्लेस्ड टू द कार्सिनोजेनिक जीन और टू द tumor inducing gene. That's why they will transmit the gene of our interest and in this particular case we need a double stranded RNA, right? So they will give a gene to the host organism which will synthesize RNA and it will make a double stranded complementary RNA same like this case and that particular thing will be inhibiting the mRNA. Okay? So that the translation will not occur. So the Agarobacterium hai, ये कुछ नेमाटोड स्पेसिफिक जीन्स भेज देगा नेमाटोड्स के अंदर. ओके, देयर आर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ जीन्स व्हिच विल सप्रेस डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ एमआरएनएस. ऑब्वियसली एक पर्टिकुलर सेगमेंट है, दिस इज अ सेगमेंट एंड वी नीड कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री एमआरएनए, सो वी नीड टू टेक दिस पर्टिकुलर सेगमेंट इनटू अकाउंट. वी विल चेक इट्स सीक्वेंस, वी विल देन चेक अनदर सीक्वेंस व्हिच इज कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री टू इट, क्योंकि वही उसको इनहिबिट कर पाएगा. इफ दिस सीक्वेंस इज नॉट कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री देन इट कैन नॉट इनहिबिट द एमआरएनए. It means that we need complementary sequences, right? So we will synthesize a complementary sequence. We will send that particular complementary sequence with the help of agrobacterium into the plants, because we are talking about plants right now. So we will not use retrovirus. Retrovirus is for animals. So agrobacterium mein hum ek particular complementary sequence dal denge. It will then inhibit or suppress the protein formation in case of mRNA. It will not lead to the synthesis of proteins. It will not lead to the synthesis of enzymes. And that's how we can prevent our plants from pests as well as parasites. Hum parasites se aur jo different kind of pathogens hain unse hamare plants ko kaise bacha sakte hain. This is a novel mechanism for it, right? This is the mechanism of RNA interference, in which RNA inhibits RNA. Double-stranded RNA is inhibiting single-stranded mRNA. That's why it is known as RNA interference or RNA silencing. Okay, because now this particular RNA is not in a state to get translated or to form proteins. This is silenced. So this is all about RNA interference mechanism. Agar aapko samajh mein aaya, tabhi like kariye is video ko. And if you are watching my video for the very first time and you found it beneficial, तो अपने दोस्तों को मेरे चैनल के बारे में बताइए, मेरी वीडियो उन तक पहुंचाइए और मेरे चैनल को जरूर सब्सक्राइब कीजिए. थैंक यू सो मच एंड स्टे ट्यून्ड फॉर द अपकमिंग वीडियोज़.